गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम भूप सिंह दरडिया, लेक्चरर इन इंग्लिश इन सूरत स्कूल महेंद्रगढ़। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू नो दैट इन माय लास्ट वीडियो आई टोल्ड यू हाउ टू राइट एन आर्टिकल एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ 12th क्लास CBSE, दैट्स इन्विटेशन राइटिंग। Dear students, invitation writing covers 3 marks in your syllabus, 1 mark reserved for the content, 1 for expression and 1 for format. 1 mark is reserved for format of an article, 1 mark reserved for contents and 1 mark is reserved for expression. So dear students, you know very well that we are social human beings. Interaction and communication between people is the common process and it is unavoidable process. It is natural process. So we want that our near and dear should join us on the important occasion. That's why we have to write invitation. I mean to say invitations play very important role in our day-to-day life, and it is a matter of joy that such kind of invitation has also been included in our CBSE, in our syllabus by the CBSE. So anyhow, today I will tell you in detail about invitation writing. So dear students, invitation are of two types. First is formal invitation and second is informal invitation. Formal invitation and informal invitation. As the word itself indicates that formal invitation are general invitations and they can be written to anybody. And they are formal in language. They are polite and courteous in language, while informal letters are meant for our near and dear. We write such type of letters to our friends, to our relatives. So formal invitations are of two types: printed invitation, and the second one is handwritten. I mean to say typed invitation, typed. There are two types of formal invitation: first of printed invitation and second one is a handwritten invitation. And dear students, you know very well about such kind of invitations, because in our daily life, when there is occasion of marriage, birthday, wedding anniversary, opening ceremony, we use such type of invitations. So now we will do in detail about printed invitation. Please attend to me. Printed invitation, they are printed in form. We take an example. You are Rakesh Sharma, son of Mr. S.K. Sharma, living at 34 Model Town, Ambala. Model Town, Ambala. Your father wants you to write a formal invitation on the auspicious occasion of your sister Anamika's marriage. Yes, dear students, please read the question again. Suppose you are Rakesh Sharma, son of Mr. S. K. Sharma, living at 34 Model Town, Ambala. Your father wants you to write a formal invitation on the auspicious occasion of your sister Anamika's marriage. So, dear students, this is the invitation which is written to many persons. So, this is the printed form of the invitation. So, please let me start. This one, you are Rakesh Sharma, son of Mr. S. K. Sharma. If a invitation, if you will write a invitation here on the auspicious marriage of your sister, dear students, please don't forget that each and every kind of invitation in the printed form are written on behalf of the head of the family, that is Mr. S. K. Sharma. So you will write the invitation on behalf of your father, Mr. S. K. Sharma. Yes, please. Yes, please start. Mr. and Mrs. S. K. Sharma. Requests the pleasure of your benign presence on the auspicious occasion of the marriage of their daughter Anamika. Yes, dear student, first of all, you will start the invitation Mr. and Mrs. S. K. Sharma is already mentioned in the question. Request the pleasure of your benign presence. Benign, it means something good. Presence on the auspicious occasion, it will be spoken occasion of the marriage of their daughter Anamika. And dear students, for your kind information, this you can have different type of forms while writing such kind of invitation. First of all, you will write the name of the host in capital form, or in a first letter of each word in a capital form, or it should be in broad letters. It should be written prominently in broad letters, as I have written on the blackboard, Mr. and Mrs. S. K. Sharma. And then you will adopt the zigzag process. This one, it will be better. Don't write like a paragraph. No, you will write in this way, as I have written on the blackboard. So first of all, you will write the name of the host. This is the name of the host. And then it is the common expression used in every kind of invitation, common expression, and after that you will write the name. Yes, once again, Mr. and Mrs. S. K. Sharma request the pleasure of your benign presence on the auspicious occasion of the marriage of their daughter Anamika. Where's one on? Son of Mr. and Mrs. R. K. Sharma, 34 Ganesh Colony, Narnon. Yes, dear students, You can write to you if it is not given in the question paper. At that time, you can imagine that Varun. You can imagine if the name is not given in the question paper. At that time, you can imagine the name of any boy here, Mr. Arun, son of Mr. and Mrs. R. K. Sharma, 34 Ganesh Colony, Narnool. You will imagine the address also, and after that, Anamika wears Varun on. Yes, please. Yes, once again, Mr. and Mrs. S. K. Sharma request your benign presence on the special occasion of the marriage of their daughter Anamika Vats Varun, son of Mr. and Mrs. R. K. Sharma, 34 Ganesh Colony, Narnool. On Thursday, 30th July, 2020 at their residence Motor Town, Ambala. Yes, dear students, and after that you will write a program. Program, you will divide it into two parts. First is on Thursday, 30th July 2020. Thursday. It doesn't matter if you write the name of the day before and after that. Yes, I have already written Thursday, 30th July 2020. And then you write reception of Barat, 5 p.m. And then Friday, 31st of July 2020, Dolly, 6 a.m. And then you will put it inside a box. So, dear students, this is the invitation. So, please, some important points to be noted. First of all, you will write the name of the host, Mr. And after that, you will mention the occasion. You will mention the time, place and venue as I have written. Don't forget to write the proper date, time and venue. And after that, you will mention the program. Such type of program are there. If the mentioning of the program in the question paper, then it is better. If there is no mentioning of the programs at that time, you can assume that only two programs in the marriage of a daughter, like reception of Barat and Dolly. And at last, you will write your left hand side RSVP. It is French expression. It means, dear students, respond if you please. Mr. and Mrs. Sharma, S.K. Sharma, as you have written above, you will mention that and here you will write with the best compliments from all relatives and friends. This is the ending point of your formal invitation in the form of printed one. So dear students, you will end this invitation, you will write your right hand side with best compliments from all relatives and friends, and your left hand side you will write RSVP Mr. and Mrs. Sharma, and you can also write your phone number 94. You can imagine in this way, you can write in this way. Yes, this is the proper formation of the printed type of invitation. So dear students, the important points to be noted in printed invitation, that first of all you will mention the name of the host. After that you will mention the date, time, venue, and that you will end the invitation in a proper way by writing this type of phrases with best compliments from all relatives, friends, and you will write your left hand side RSVP. Here you will mention the name of the person which is given at the top of your answer. So dear student, after that, after written all these things, you will put all the matter inside a box. Don't forget to put all the matter inside a box. So this was something how to write a printed invitation. So dear students, if you have any kind of problem, you will contact me. But and in our next video, we will discuss about the next type of formal invitation. That's all for today. Thanks and have a nice day.